This is the Todd Shapiro Show on Canada Talks, SiriusXM 167.
Courtney Vanderbilt, how are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm really good, thank you. It's so nice to see you. You know, we're hard to believe, 8-9 days away. Yeah. I guess it's 8 days away. From the Scotiabank Road Hockey to Conquer Cancer. It's one of the greatest events. You know, this is our fourth year strong in it as a show. And how long has the charity been around for?
Yeah, so this event actually is going into its 9th year. Guinness World Record event. So it's actually the largest road hockey fundraiser in the world.
Come on.
Yeah, so started back in 2011.
That is unbelievable. And then you've had an increase of teams this year, from what I understand.
Unbelievable. And you know what? The industry, it's been peer-to-peer really challenging to get people on board and get them engaged. But this event really has been an exception. And we've had year-over-year growth. We're actually tracking to have about 15% growth over last year and trending to have, hopefully, fingers crossed, the biggest year yet.
That's amazing stuff. And when you say biggest in terms of fundraising efforts as well, in terms of like a dollar number?
You know what? The majority of our funds, believe it or not, they are raised in obviously the last week leading up to the event. So hard to believe I bite all my nails off every year, 1 week out. But yeah, definitely trending to have the biggest year. And obviously we'll announce that at our opening ceremony, September 28th.
Yeah, if you haven't been there, and I think you probably, if you listen to the program a lot, you've heard this messaging about the day itself. How it's one of these, like, really, it's just a miraculous day in terms of community, in terms of support, in terms of really perspective, because you see, you know, sadly, what some cancer patients are going through. You hear stories sometimes of loss, and it's a very emotional one, yet that emotion is then overcome with you know, and it's okay to say this, I think, with joy, because people come together, you're doing a sport you love, and you're around people who all want to make a great difference, and the Princess Margaret Cancer Foundation, being one of the top hospitals in the world, top cancer research centers in the world, is making that difference. And it's so great to hear that.
For sure. And I think Glenn Healy really does say it best in our opening ceremonies. He says, you know what, this is the sea of humanity and everyone who's there, and there's over 3,000 people that join us for opening ceremonies. They've all made a choice to be there. And at the end of the day, we have busy lives with work, with family, with every extracurricular activity that we're doing. And it's just unbelievable to see how people have made a choice to be there. And you know what, it's $10,000 a team. It's no easy feat to be able to raise that. And even, you know, we're really heavily supported by the corporate community. But 30% of our teams are also community teams comprised of family and friends coming together on this day. So really emotional, and it's a really unique event to be a part of, for sure. Yeah,
definitely well said. And when it comes to the fundraising, you know, one of the messages we like to get across, and it does usually end up being that last week, year after year. I probably didn't even hustle as hard off the mic as I do, because we've been talking about it every day for months. But the fundraisers for us, we're at 7-8 grand. Normally we get to 20-25 or something. We'll get there, but it's amazing how it really is that last week. So I almost just waited. I'm gonna go harder. Do you get a lot of that from sort of the, you know, people involved, that, you know, we're saving it for now?
Oh, absolutely. And the celebrity draft deadline is September 25th at midnight, so we have a lot of calls coming in, you know, 11:30 p.m. September 25th, of people that want to make donations and teams want to see where they are on their ranks. And it's unique because we have the leaderboard on the website, so you can see where you're ranking against other teams. We have 37 celebrities on board this year that teams can actually draft to play with them throughout the day. So it's pretty incredible.
And who are some of those great celebs? And a couple big announcements even in the last few weeks.
Yeah, absolutely. So you might have heard 2 days ago we had Biz Nasty on air, who's going to be coming down from New York this year. He was making a joke about bringing some of that pink Whitney down with him, which would be fantastic. We have Doug Gilmore, Paul Coffey, just to name a few, a lot of really big names that are coming out to support Princess Margaret and help to accelerate cancer research.
That's incredible. Such big names. And then you'll see like a lot of just, you know, old beauties there, and some incredible, are some of the female Canadian representatives coming again for Team Canada as well?
Absolutely. Yeah. So we're really fortunate to have everyone getting behind this event. And you're right, not just celebrities. We have individuals like Peter Mansbridge that's coming out from Stratford. We have a lot of media personalities, obviously Todd Shapiro coming out on the day. But we're just so fortunate to see every walk of life, you know, every demographic, every type of individual, young, old, coming behind and supporting this event.
And our buddy Carlo Koliakovo is going to be a big part of it this year, too.
Definitely.
He's a beauty from TSN. The TSN guys are really getting behind it, aren't they?
Absolutely. You know what? We're so fortunate to have Bell Media support. We'll actually be doing a live to air on game day as well from 11 to 2. So TSM will be actually broadcasting from the site, and a few of our sponsors, Scotiabank, Sonnet, along with a few others, are actually going to be doing their interviews from the site as well.
Yeah, and we've gotten to know so many of your sponsors through the show, Longo's, you know, Scotiabank representatives, and they're it's, you know, it's nice because, you know, listen, at the end of the day, sponsorship is sponsorship, and it gets companies' names out there. Let's be real about what some of that stuff is. But, you know, there's a reason why they're sponsoring this event. It's beyond just getting a name out there. It's beyond just corporate good. It's because they're attached one way or another to making sure we do whatever we can to eradicate and get rid of this disease, because it's affected them personally in one form or another. And when you hear the stories, there's a reason why they're sponsors, a reason why they want their money going to this cause, because ultimately it continues to make a massive difference.
Oh, definitely. And you know what? Right now, 1 in 2 Canadians are being diagnosed with cancer in their lifetime. What a lot of people don't realize is we're not just impacting people here in Toronto with the work that we're doing. It's really having a global impact. And we're one of the top 5 cancer research centers in the world, as you had mentioned. So
how does that work in terms of, is there a lot of synergies between the cancer centers and doing the research and sharing information?
Oh, absolutely.
I never thought to ask it. Yeah.
Yeah, no, it's such a great question. We're collaborating with centers right across the world, different continents. We're sharing information, sharing our key learnings. Like, we're not about making discoveries and keeping them here just for people in the GTA to benefit. It's really global collaboration to make an impact and working with centers right across the world.
Is there certain storylines and great progress that like, do you know any of sort of announcements on that side from the Princess Margaret Cancer Foundation?
Yeah, absolutely. You know what? We always get the question, you know, well, is the government not funding all the work that you're doing? And I guess, you know, that's a different conversation. And I say, in a perfect world, that would be great. The government is focused on basic care, but philanthropy really helps to accelerate innovation at Princess Margaret. And I look just at the 5-year survival rates alone and go back to the 1940s. The 5-year survival rate was 25%. Fast forward to today, and the 5-year survival rate is 60%. We have more than doubled the 5-year survival rate for cancer patients, which is absolutely incredible. But what I like to say is that 40%, you know, yes, we've doubled them, but we still have 40% way to go. And at Princess Margaret alone, we're seeing 18,000 new cancer patients each and every year.
18,000, my goodness. And it's... Because everyone has these stories, so you just sort of never know when a phone call comes in, when someone in your family, whether yourself, it's a reminder that you should always live life in a much more, I think, appreciative and grateful way. Be good to people, because you do never know what can happen. And you know, we have all this great now support to make things better, but it's not an excuse to. What I'm saying is, you got to take each and every day with a real big smile on your face. And the other thing you should do, which is okay to take pleasure from, and this is the thing I'll always remind people, is that don't feel bad about taking pleasure from giving. Mm-hmm. It's okay to feel good and, you know, put your shoulders back, have a stretch in your walk, because you helped out something today. And when you give, and you give 10 bucks, 20 bucks, 100 bucks, I don't want to sound like a telethon or anything, but it feels like it feels great because you're helping out. And that's what we have. That's all. Yeah. You don't take it with you. Help out now so other people can continue to be here too. And by the way, the survivors themselves, my goodness, do their families and everyone get in and help out like there's no tomorrow. You know, they really get behind it.
Oh, absolutely. And you couldn't be more right. Really, it doesn't matter if it's a $5 donation, a $500 donation. Every single dollar counts. And if you can't donate, there's so many ways to get behind this event. You can come out and referee. You can volunteer on the day. You can come out and cheer on the teams. Like, there really are so many ways to get involved in this event. And we actually expect to have about 20,000 unique donations that'll come to building up that grand fundraising total as of September 28th.
My goodness, it's all going down at Woodbine, and that's on September 28th. Starts early. Starts real early. I'm always a little late.
But not you, Todd.
No, I know. I'm always a little late. I got kids, and that was always my excuse. Starts early, and it's an amazing day, and we've been blessed with such, you know, whether it was rain or too hot or a perfect day. It's just, it always works out. The total last year was, remind me.
$2.7 million.
$2.7 million.
Yeah, $20 million over the last 8 years.
Wow.
Unbelievable.
$20 million. And by the way, let's get to $3 million this year. How great would that be?
Yeah, we're trying. We're working at it. I mean, with, you know, everyone that's backing this event, from the sponsors to the donors to the participants, the volunteers, I mean, it's an endless list of individuals that support us, but we're absolutely pushing to try and hit that $3 million this year.
Who, do you want to drop some names? There's some real bit, like, I know our man Sean St. John's huge.
You know
from
what?
National
There's
Bank.
So many individuals. I mean, a lot of people will ask, especially with the growth that we've had on the event, you know, how do you grow year over year? Number one, definitely sponsors who continue to come out. Longo's obviously, you know, was a founding sponsor. Scotiabank, our title sponsor. Pizza Pizza, our presenting sponsor, amongst others. But really, our executive committee plays such a huge role in this event. And who the executive members are really corporate members in the community, as well as community ambassadors that come behind the event. What they do is they enter a team and they recruit other teams to get behind us. And it's actually incredible. So this year alone, we have 60 new teams that are participating. It's our top number of new teams, obviously, since 2011 that have ever participated in the event before. So it's incredible to see that close to 30% of our teams have never participated. We've had substantial growth year over year, and really our executive committee has played such a huge role in that.
Who do you think is going to go number one in the draft?
I guess it really depends on who that team is, right? I mean, if I were picking, yeah. I mean, maybe this is a little bit biased, but I think Biz Nasty would maybe be one of my picks. There's so many incredible celebrities.
Yeah, Paul Biz Nasty is, he's become such an amazing personality, and he's branded himself real well because he's all out. You know, he'll say what's on his mind. It's the new day and age of media. But you know, with a guy like that, like the intent is the good intent is there. Like you feel that vibe from the guy. As tough and as honest as he is at times, but and he's so supportive of so much. I love it. Even he's just supportive of hockey, but he's supportive of the community and now giving back. It's nice to know guys like that are involved.
And you know what? The celebrity draft really helps push the fundraising needle because it generates that friendly competition. So the more celebrities we can get on board, the more money we raise for cancer research and the greater impact we have. So I'm really looking forward to having Biz Nasty on board. And I don't know if you heard, but he's looking for a chief hockey officer. So I said he can borrow the role for 6 months, but
right?
The title is mine.
You're taking it. You're taking the role.
Oh, yeah. So...
Well, listen, Courtney, I'm so proud of everything you guys all do, and I'm so grateful to be a part of it and that we've teamed up. And I take a lot of pleasure in talking about this as much as we do because it's never you can never talk about this stuff too little, meaning there's always opportunity to help out. And if you're listening at home and, you know, you know some family members who have gone through this or are going through this, first off, I just hope, you know, the best for the situation. And if you can give back, you know, to team up to conquercancer.ca. If you want to help out our team, please go to the ToddShapiroShow.com, the top banner link there. We'll take you to our team page. And, you know, we're just really appreciative. If you just maybe don't even have money, but you want to go and check out the event to get involved in it next year, September 28th, come do it. Mm-hmm. That's cool. Thanks, Courtney.
Thanks, Todd.
Where can people follow you?
Courtney MV.
What's the MV?
They'll find it on my my middle and last initial.
But you have no E in your name. Does that confuse people?
It does.
NY, the
yeah.
NY?
I get a lot of E. I'm not the one to correct people.
Yeah.
You know, they can spell my name as long as it's Courtney. I've seen different variations. But, yeah, you can find my handle on your tweet today.
Awesome. And that celebrity draft on the 27th at the Hockey Hall of Fame. So if you get in the top teams, you'll be invited there for it. It's going to be really exciting. And again, Woodbine Racetrack, if you don't know where that is, well, you could use Google or you could just go to 555 Rexdale Boulevard. Again, the Scotiabank Road Hockey to Conquer Cancer happening in 8 days from now. And thank you to Courtney and the entire staff.
Game on cancer.
Let's go do this. Thanks again.
This is the Todd Shapiro Show on Canada Talks, Sirius XM 167.